Hey dreamers, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Akmal Hussain and I'm a class 12 student at St. Paul's Day School. And you might know him. He is a chief guest of our today video. And I will let him to introduce himself. So please.
Akmal, first of all, thanks for inviting me on your channel. For those who don't know
my
me,
pleasure.
I am MD Samimuddin Molla. Currently, I'm a first professional MBBS student at Midnapur Medical College.
So here we are doing a podcast type of video. But our setup is not professional, but we managed to do so. So I said, let's do it. I have a bunch of questions which I am going to ask him, and he will be answering those. And if you want to ask any question, his Instagram ID is in the description link below, and you can go and follow him and question him as much as you want, and there is no limitations. So watch the video till end. Here is my first question. So from where did you completed your schooling, and what was your performance at your schooling days?
I did my schooling from Akra Shaktiga Rabindra Vidyapeeth, which is a government school itself, and I scored around 89% in 10th and around 81% in 12th.
That's good. And my 10th rank was so bad, it was around 58%, but I am working hard for my results. Let's see what will be the result in my 12th.
Listen, 10th marks does not matter in NEET, so don't worry about it.
I'm literally working hard for my 12th exam. So my second question is, when did you started dreaming to become a doctor?
After completing my 12th, or around 2018, when I got to know about biomedicals, basically Dr. Gitendra Singh, he's one of my inspiration and his work inspired me a lot. And other factor is my father, he's one of my motivator. He had more desire to make me a doctor rather than me.
Hearing about your father, I would like to say something about my father. He is the only motivator to me, who has motivated me towards my study and show me the path to become a doctor, and I will surely fulfill his dream one day. So moving on to my next question, there is some misconception that only English medium board student can become a doctor, or a doctor's child deserve to become a doctor. What would you like to say on?
See, you can take me as an example that I am a student of West Bengal State Board itself, and behind my family there is no doctor, and if I can crack NEET, so anybody, if he or she work hard for NEET, she or he can definitely crack NEET.
Your answer is definitely right, but the one who deserves to become a doctor will become a doctor.
Yes.
Not only doctor's child become a doctor, or an English medium student can become a doctor. He is also from West Bengal board, and it is a Bengali medium, not an English medium or CBSE board or ICSE board. So everyone should be motivated towards their dream, not only hearing about the society that doctor's child can be a doctor or something like that misconception. So moving on to my next question, when did you crack NEET? I mean, which year?
After overcoming so much ups and downs and drama of NEET postponement, finally I cracked NEET in 2020.
My next question is, what was your marks at NEET 2020 and marks in all three different subjects?
Okay. So first of all, come to the total marks. I got 580 out of 720, and individual marks are, I got 315 in biology, in chemistry 145, and in physics 120.
As you said, you got 315 in biology. So coming towards biology, what was your strategy and what make you different from the others that you got selection in NEET?
Basically, I am an official commando of biomentors, so that's why I was totally dependent on biomentors. So your viewer who know about biomentors, they can relate that biomentors upload daily video lectures, and I used to watch all lectures for PCB, and then I used to solve for TPP and prepare for tests. These are common for all three subjects. Okay. For biology, my first priority was to complete the lectures, then DPP, and then test. Apart from that, as you all know that more than 90% of MCQs are directly from NCERT. So my target was to read NCERT in multiple times. And then I used to figure out the MCQs from the lines which examiner can be asked in the exam. And as well as I solved some MCQ books and UIQs of different exam.
As you said, you got 145 in chemistry. So what was special you have done for chemistry?
As you all know that there are three parts in the chemistry: organic, inorganic, and physical. So first of all, come with organic. For organic, I used to read NCERT and try to clear all the concept. And one thing I wanna suggest here, that try to give more priority in GOC. If we clear with GOC, then upcoming chapters in organic of 12th will be easy for you.
What about inorganic?
Okay, for inorganic, NCERT is must, like biology. So we need to read NCERT inorganic multiple times, and don't ignore any charts, figures, diagram that is given in the NCERT for inorganic.
And physical?
For physical, I used to read NCERT twice, and for physical, I would like to say that give more priority towards the numerical questions, because in physical, most of the questions are numerical based, but don't ignore the theoretical part, because last 2-3 years, there are so many theoretical MCQs in NEET paper.
So thank you for your suggestions. Moving on to the next subject and the hardest subject for NEET aspirants, that is physics. What you did special for physics?
For physics, first of all, try to clear all concepts, then try to develop interest in the subject, and solve MCQ as much as you can, and try to give the test. That's all.
So thank you for your suggestions. Now coming to the most happiest part, what was the reaction of your family, especially your father, after your selection?
Yeah, 16 October 2020, the day is still memorable for me. On that day, I checked my result by own, and then I came to my father and let him watch. Then the celebration begins. That day was awesome for me, because that day made a great transition in my life. That day made me medico from non-medico. Before declaration of official result, I had not disclosed my result to anybody, but my father believed on me, and he made a decorated thermocol on which my name was printed, like NEET Warrior MD Samiuddin Molla, and that was totally a surprise for me. Then we celebrate a lot, and still I can recall the happy faces of my sisters, my brothers, my cousin, my parents and neighbors. Then we distribute some sweets to our neighbors, and some of them offers me some sweets and laddus.
It feels very good to hear about your celebration, and I really liked the thermocol which your father made for you. And I think I'll be also celebrating like you in future and make my family as proud as yours. And mind you guys, Samim has given us a biryani party to our friends. Obviously, when friend is becoming a doctor, he has to give a party to all our friends. And वो दोस्त ही क्या जो बिरयानी बिना पार्टी का दोस्त को डॉक्टर बनने दे. And now, how is your MBBS life going?
As you know that pursuing MBBS was one of my dream. So after clearing NEET and entering into medical college, I feel that I am blessed. And there is a big misconception that after clearing NEET, life में तो मज़े ही मज़े है, life is set. But ऐसा नहीं है यार, MBBS में बहुत पढ़ना पड़ता है, ठीक है? But if you are good in time management, you can pursue your dream and your hobbies side by side. But don't get demotivated, पढ़ाई के साथ साथ entertainment भी होता है. If you are good in time management, you can pursue your hobby side by side.
So my last question for today, what are your further goals and what you wanted to be in future?
To be very honest, I have not decided till now about my future, about NEET PG or USMLE. I did not decide it till now.
I have ended up my questions. Now only one question is left. What would you like to suggest to me and my viewers towards their dream and achieving their medical college?
Lastly, I wanna suggest one thing, that try to remain motivated and work hard for your dream until you achieve your dream medical college. If I can, you will also can. Thank you.
It feels really motivated to talk to you, and it motivated me a lot, I can't tell you. And thanks for giving me your time. It feels really motivating to talk to you, and I am feeling really motivated from inside, I can't tell you. And thank you for me giving your time. Although you are really busy, I have seen your schedule. So if you have watched my vlog with him, I have told you that if he is opening any YouTube channel, I will let you know. And the day comes and he has opened our YouTube channel, you can go and check out his videos. He's working really hard for his channel. I will give the link in the description box below. You can go and check out his channel. And I will meet you on the next video. Until then, take care of yourself, take care of the loving ones around you, and I will meet you on the next video. Bye bye.